Morning, guys. You know, life can be tough. There's pain, there's loss, there's bad decisions and consequences of those bad decisions. There's broken relationships, there's disease that takes loved ones from us. There's children who go down a bad path. They're adults that go down bad paths. There's loss of work, bad finances, foreclosures, repossessions. And then to make things worse, often we try and hide those things or cover them up or pretend like they have not happened, which just makes a very, very difficult situation even worse. Pretend is not a good idea. But being a follower of Jesus, I've experienced a lot of those things. And having Jesus in my life has made dealing with those things a lot easier. It hasn't made them go away. It hasn't stopped them from happening. But Jesus never promised that would be the case. In fact, Jesus promised that we would have trouble in this world. Now some might say, well, yeah, duh, okay. But I think Jesus made that statement as a preemptive, as preemptive proof that a lot of what is preached by a lot of preachers today is just simply not biblically accurate. And I think Jesus said it to set people up to understand that just because you're following me doesn't mean that everything is going to be peachy keen. Jesus' life wasn't peachy keen. And so why should ours be? But this is the difference. Jesus made the statement of, I give you peace. Not as the world gives, give I unto you, but I give you my peace. And that's that's the biggest difference in the world, right there. And that is that Jesus gives a peace that this world cannot understand, does not understand. In fact, there's so much about Jesus that if you have not connected with him, you cannot understand. But my point is that this isn't all there is. This is not the end. And if we live our lives as though this is all there is, no wonder there are many people who are having nervous breakdowns or constant anxiety or can't seem to make relationships work. I can't say that I've ever not had Jesus as a part of my life. I can say that I haven't always walked close with him. I can't say that I'm even as close to him now as I once was. Just confession time. But the point is that I can't imagine trying to get through a lot of the crap that life throws our way, that we find on the path of our journey, without him being a part of it. And I know so many people who have pushed him aside, and they're living a life of turmoil and chaos, and I honestly don't see how they get through it. And this is the thing. Most of the people that I know are actually just getting through it. I mean, there's no peace, there's no joy, there's no happiness. And what amazes me is how they seem to be totally unwilling or oblivious to the idea of giving Jesus a chance. To just simply make the load easier to carry. I read this morning, someone posted on Facebook, Bible verse from Peter, one of Peter's letters. Cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. Jesus wants to bear those burdens that we have, and often we carry them needlessly. Especially in the area of broken relationships. Sometimes we brought those on ourselves, sometimes we haven't. But at any rate, Jesus is all about reconciliation and restoration. And if we just give Him a chance, that relationship may not be fixable because of the other person, but it can be made clean. The slate, as far as you are concerned, your side of the situation can be made clean. And you can have peace over it. And you can have joy after the fact. Trust me on this. So, give it all to Him. He's not going to put a Band-Aid on it. He's not even going to put methylate or mercurochrome or iodine on it. He's just simply going to hold your hand and walk you through it. And you'll be the better for it. And having gone through it, you can step up to the side of someone else who's going through the exact same thing, and you can be Jesus to them. That's what all this is about, folks. It's what it's all about. Let's pray. Father, thank You for this day. Thank You for Your great love. Thank You for reaching out to us. Thank You for offering us peace in the midst of turmoil, and love in the midst of hate, and joy in the midst of sadness. Father, I pray that You'll be with those who need You. We all need You, but some don't know that they need You, and therefore that's more than half the battle. I pray that You'll quicken within them the knowledge of their need for You, and they will reach out for You in the darkness that they are, because You are not far from any of us. Again, thank You for loving us. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys. Good talking to you, and I will talk to you again soon.